Hi everybody, Diana here at Sew in Common. Welcome into Workshop Wednesday. Now I know this is actually posting on Friday the 2nd. We have had a family emergency, still kind of ongoing, but more under control than it was. It's been a rough week, everybody. You guys know how that gets, right? Sometimes life does not do what we want it to do. And so I appreciate you all understanding this. But this is Workshop Wednesday. And today we're going to be talking about our Charm Star Runner. Our Charm Star Runner is what we made this month using charm packs. Now, all of this was from two of the same charm packs, and I love how it turned out. And I want to talk to you about the star. So I'm going to take this part down, this square down. We're going to talk about the quilting, never you fear. But I want to talk about the star. I like how this star turned out. And the one reason I like it is because of doing the dark corners. It helped that star to pop out a little bit more. And when it's all together, it gives that block kind of an interesting look, almost as if you had more blocks like this, you'd get a secondary pattern. Excuse me, a secondary pattern. And I love it when our quilts like just form these secondary patterns. I think that's a very cool look. I love it. But some of you have emailed me and said, I don't like my star. It's too busy. Okay, I get that. It's your Charm Star Runner. So let's talk about what we can do if you don't like the fact that this turned out busier than you wanted it to be. Alrighty. So one of the things you can do is you can leave your four corners and you can leave your center, because those are all solid fabric blocks from your charm pack. But I think what you're not liking so much is your points. And you can see my points are pretty busy, but I did choose lighter colored fabrics to work as the background. So something that you can do is leave your center and your four corners, and then you can choose two fabrics, a light for the background and the same fabric for all of the points. When you're making, these are your 8 half square triangles that you're making. And when you make them from the two exact same fabrics, a background fabric and your primary for your star points. That'll help it to pop out. If you don't like the center, if the center is still too busy for you, use the same fabric that you choose for your corner or for your points, and make it so your star is then a solid star. I love that look of a solid star. We don't see it a whole lot anymore, but I love it because there's so many beautiful fabrics. We try to fit them all in, which is what we did here with the charm packs. But if you want a solid star, then replace these with solids. Or if you're going to do a print for your points, do it all in the same print. That would be fine. Now, the other thing that you can do, the other thing that would make this star as it is pop out more, is if I had had more of this fabric and used it as my background fabric in my half square triangles, you could do that. So don't use the four fabrics that you have in the corners. Choose another fabric from your stash and do it for the backgrounds of all your half square triangles and do it for the solid squares here. That will make this pop out more. Okay, those are a couple of ways that you can change that. But I would definitely leave your 16 patch square blocks on the top and the bottom to add some liveliness and some interest to that pattern. But if you want to change around the star, there's no reason why you can't. The idea was for us to use the charm pack, but if it's really not in the end your thing, that's okay. It's your Charm Star Runner. You can do what you want with it, right? That's our whole idea. You're the artist, you're the quilter, you decide. I give you this information and then you run with it. You can change it up all you want and you aren't going to hurt my feelings. Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and pin this back up here. Sorry, you're looking at the back of me, but I have to stand up to do this. There. All righty. So what we end up with is a runner that is 12 inches finished across and 36 inches up and down. It's a perfect size for a coffee table. If you have a smaller kitchen table, can also be perfect for that. It's also perfect for the top of a dresser that is wider. Like we have a chest of drawers in our bedroom. One is a high boy and one is lower and wider with only the three drawers. This is perfect for the top of that as well. So if you wanted to make it double wide, you would need more charms if you want it double wide. And then you could use it even as a bed runner if you wanted to. I love the idea of a bed runner. And we're going to be doing one of those here in the not too distant future as one of our projects. But you've got your 16 patch on top and on bottom. Let's see, can I change that? There you go. You can see that a little bit better. It's hard to get the whole thing in here. And then your star in the center. Now, someone asked me, could they do a star on top and a star on bottom and just one of these 16 patches in the center because they're going to set a bowl of fruit in the center and they didn't want it covering up the star. That is an awesome idea. And that idea comes from our friend Carol out in Idaho. Carol, that's an awesome idea. Instead of making two 16 patches for the end, make two stars, one on top, one on bottom, and put your 16 patch right in the center. And that way, if you've got a bowl or a vase of flowers or anything you want, you can put that here in the center. And then you set your stuff on it, and it's not a problem. And I personally love that idea. I like to do that. That's one reason I actually like this star as well, is because the center is big enough that I can put something here and you see a little design around it. But if you want to do star top and bottom and the 16 patch in the center, go for it. I love it. Carol, please post a photograph when you're done over at our Facebook page, Sew in Common, so we can see it. And if any of you want, post your photos over there. I want to see them. I want to be able to share them with everyone, whether you do them as we've done them here or if you kind of switch it up and do your own thing, because that is one of the number one ways we get inspired as quilters, is to see what our quilting friends do with their projects. That's like the number one way we get inspired by other people. So that's how we do this. Now let's talk briefly about the quilting for this. So 12 wide, 36. Remember to measure for your quilting. Now it's pretty easy with the Build-A-Quilt system because we know that we get that accurate size. And that size is between your guideline marks. But if you want to give it a double check, that's fine. Now, I always back off by half an inch. So it's a 12 inch finished. My quilt design, if I were going to do it in one hooping, I'd get out my big 12 by 12 hoop and I'd do an 11 and a half inch by 11 and a half inch design. However, I know a lot of you don't have those big hoops. That's okay. Because what you have, remember, in each one, whether you're doing it in this one or this one, you have 4 6x6 blocks here, right? So here's four, here's four, here's four, here's four. 6x6, that means you need a 5.5 inch finish. You can do that in your 5x7 hoop for your quilting. So you would do 1, 2, 3, 4 hoopings per bigger square. So you'd do 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 hoopings, but they're small. They're going to go really quickly, you're going to have that quilted in no time at all. In fact, that's what I am going to do for this so that you all can see how that works. And you're going to see that before the end of the video here. So I pattern-wise, do whatever you like. I think because this is very busy and we've used the charm pack, I'm just going to use a stipple design. I don't want anything fancy schmancy on here that people are going to have to look and try and figure it out. I'm just going to do a stipple and it's going to be done quick and easy. All right. So the next part of our video, you're going to see, I'm going to show it to you quilted, but it won't be bound yet. I probably will bind it over the weekend when I have a little bit more time. So let's go take a look at what this is going to look like once we do it. But remember, if you have a bigger hoop and you want to do a bigger design, that's fine. Double check your measurement, back it off by half an inch, because the half inch really gives you plenty, just enough room to bind and just have a little bit of it around the outside. If you do it the full size, you're going to cover up just a little bit of the quilting. And some people like that look, but I like that backed off look better. So if you can either do it the full size or back it off by half an inch. My recommendation is to back it off by half an inch. And like I said, I'm just going to do a stipple. However, if you change your star and it's very solid and very plain color, or not plain, but it's a one fabric, then you could certainly do a quilt design in the center and then do a different design in your points. And then do something different in your corners. That's a lot of different quilt designs you'd have to come up with, but it would be pretty. But because this is so busy, I just like the idea of a simple stipple. Let's go take a look at that right now. Okay, everybody, we're back and my runner is quilted. Here's the whole thing quilted. I sewed my three squares together. You can see that's the fabric I used on the back, little stars, but that green is a pretty close match to some of my other green. And since it's backing, that's fine by me. I don't know what I'm going to do for the binding yet. I have to think about that. I have to look at what I have and think about that. Maybe this darker blue or something, if I have something like that. But it was super simple. The whole process of quilting this took me less than 20 minutes because I did just what I told you earlier, is I did 12 hoopings of the four blocks. So one hooping, two hoopings, that sort of thing. And I just did a very simple 5.5 by 5.5 inch stipple. When you print out your templates, make sure you print them out with a crosshair on them. And if you don't know how to do that, or if you don't know what that's about, I'm going to link my video on resizing quilt designs at the end of this video, because it's really important for you when it comes to doing your finished quilting. It'll be very, very helpful for you. I use a sticky back template paper. You can use regular paper if you like, but this is still usable. So I just write right on it what the size is. Now I'll put that over into my design file folder. But I did every fourth one. And let me show you, I used this thread. It is my favorite. It's that minty color. It's Isochord's 5220. Isochord has less sheen to it. It's not matte, but it has less sheen. And I like that for this type of quilting. But if you want to use cotton, you're welcome to use cotton bobbin and cotton top thread, so your threads match. And so the cotton and cotton colors can be different, but cotton and cotton for this polyester and polyester bobbin and top thread. But if you want to use polyester and you want it to have that cotton look, look for a thread that says that it is cottonized. Cottonized thread is a polyester thread that has been manipulated. It sews like a dream. And but the manipulation takes the shine off of it, so it looks matte or like cotton thread. I love it. There are several brands out there. I have a really hard time finding good colors. The one brand I use doesn't have very many colors at all, and they don't have this color. So I'm always looking for a good cottonized thread. Or look for a thread, polyester that says it's a matte thread, a matte finished polyester. That'll do the same thing for you and give you that cotton look, but the strength of the polyester. I did a 3.0 stitch length on my design. You can kind of see it in our box right here. And that 3.0 stitch length gives a really beautiful hand finished look. I also used my dime magnetic hoop. I don't use my dime hoops for piecing because I don't feel like they hold my stabilizer tight enough. I use my regular hoop. But for my quilting, I use this. It works like a dream. Let me just do this real quick. I'm going to take my template and I'm going to stick it on my one of my squares. Now, this was so easy because the north, south, east, west lines on here matched up with the north, south, east, west lines in the square itself. So it made it super simple to line it up. The nice thing about a magnetic hoop, this always stays on the bed of the machine. Okay, you don't have to take it off with each hooping. That makes your hoopings go a lot quicker. Like I said, this whole thing took me less than 20 minutes, like 18 and three quarters minutes or something. So I've got that on here. I'm just gonna line this right up. There we go. Put this on here. And now this would be under my needle. I would use my, when I put this on here, I slide this so it sits under the needle. Then I slide this back on. And then I just use my machine features to get that needle right in the center. And because you can kind of slide it to where you want it to be, you're talking like just a couple little manipulations, couple up, couple down, couple to the side, and you'll be right where you need to be. And then I'm off to the races. And so it just took no time at all. I am going to, did I tell you, I would link at the end the video I did on resizing your designs. It's really important. It'll be very helpful for you for resizing your quilting designs. You can use any quilting design you like. I just put together a little stipple because it's so busy, you're not going to see any really beautiful quilting on here. So I just stippled it, and that's, I think I even tell you in that video, the stipple is my favorite quilting design of all time. I love it because it doesn't take away from my piecing. So that is the finishing of the star-crossed runner. And it was fun to do. I loved using my charm packs. I told you earlier, though, how to change up that center star if you think the star is too busy done in the charm pack. Okay. So next Wednesday, because it'll be the week before Valentine's Day, we're going to do a little project with our friends, the Queen of Heart block set. You get the 4-inch finished, the 5-inch finished, and the 8-inch finished. And we're going to do a little, project with it next Wednesday workshop before we start a whole nother round of stuff. This can be found over at the website, www.sewandcon. I think the whole pattern set is like $1.50 or something. So not much money, and you'll be all set to go. And you can use this then for lots of other things, but we'll be talking about that next Wednesday. If you need to contact me, of course you can at support@sewandcommon.com. Please start posting your photos of your finished designs at the Facebook page so that I can share them with people and so that I can see them. Like I said earlier, that's how we inspire one another. If you have not already subscribed to the channel, we'd love to have you here in the Sew in Common studio with us every Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday, and little short videos throughout the week. So please subscribe, click the little bell to set your notifications, and please like and share the videos. Those likes and shares help others find us. And of course, we can never have too many quilty friends. Until next time, everybody, I'm Diana here at Sew in Common. It's been a pleasure to do the charm cross, charm star runner with you all this month and work with our charm packs. Great way to use our charm packs with the Build-A-Quilt system. Until next time, everybody, have a great week. Sew life beautiful.